John out there? All right, let's get this thing moving.
About 60 miles north of Atlanta in the Dawson Forest in Dawsonville, Georgia. Now back in the 50s, this area, this stretch of land, which is now a park owned by Atlanta, was actually called the Georgia Nuclear Aircraft Laboratory. And what they did was they tested the effects of radiation on military aircraft, materials, other different forms of transportation, all right here in the woods. In a way, this is Atlanta's Area 51.
The sign stands just off US Highway 19, about 60 miles north of Marietta. From that point, it directs traffic down the access road to Air Force Plant 67, operated for the United States Air Force by Lockheed Georgia Division.
Now the land itself stretches over a couple of miles, but there are three main points. There's the hot cell building, there's the cooling well, cooling center, as well as the reactor. Now this is the staircase, the building that housed the staircase that goes down into the tunnels. At one point it was completely closed off. They put dirt over it, they sealed it up, but as you can see, there is one of the doorways that is open, and we can get down inside it. Now, I honestly don't know about snakes. I don't know if I want to attempt that. Oh, I don't know. Let's see what we can do here. Holy fuck. Doesn't look, I don't hear any snakes or anything. Old light fixture, air duct. That's mud. Burn, go away, fucker. Now this doesn't really look like it's anything. I said, from what I can tell online, it looked like this was an entrance to the caves themselves, but it is just a room for what, I don't know, maybe an office. There wasn't any like stairs or anything. It was just one giant open room.
You sure?
Yeah, I looked. It was like a mud floor.
Buried by the ground.
I didn't see anything. There was like an old, really old like light fixture above. So that was a bust. This location is not where we can get into the underground tunnel, but right here is the hot cell building. Now the hot cell building that's behind me is where they took all the materials that they were testing with the radiation. They would put them in this building and they would monitor the effects the radiation had on them to use. It's pretty massive.
Yeah.
As you can see, it's walled up pretty good. Any chance to get in is not going to happen. At least not from this side.
Got a dame, got money. 30, 29, 4. Told anybody he wasn't gone. Hit that open road. There wasn't me no race. V8, yes sir. Called Brother Jane and knocked there in. He falls a tree.
Now the hot cell building itself and that small little structure that we went into thinking that it would be some sort of entrance to some sort of tunnel. It's pretty much all that you can see at this part of the location. I'm gonna finish up getting a couple more pictures and then move on in search of the reactor itself. Hey baby, how you doing?
Hello.
Ready to get a move on to see what else we can find?
Uh-huh. See how like all the trees look burnt and they're broken off?
Yeah.
Like a lot of them look like that. I wonder if it's from radiation.
You also notice that like it's like no wildlife. Except for like the mosquitoes, there's like nothing. I haven't even seen a bird. I've been looking up in the trees.
Mm-hmm. I know about her.
Now the hot cell building is surrounded by not one, not two, but three chain link fences and barbed wire. We found a way to get through it successfully, unscathed. Highly an adventurer. It's a big varmint.
See the rebar of them?
Yeah. There?
Maybe it's the tunnels caved in.
Possibly. I was able, saw a video online. People were able to get down inside the tunnels, but for most of the year, because of where it is, where it's at sea level, it's flooded. Mm-hmm. So there's a video of somebody in a, like a rubber boat, like an inner tube boat, paddling through the tunnels. It's actually pretty neat. Yeah.
I wonder what's under there, or if it's just a platform.
Now the land now is mostly trails that are open to the public. You can ride your bicycle, you can ride your horse, if you have a horse, on the trail. It does cost a little bit of money, they ask for some money. But the parking lot here at the main entrance to Dawson Forest is a lot of concrete slabs. It looks like a parking lot, but in all actuality, it was the foundation of a lot of the office buildings, the administration buildings at the time. Now, I think it was 1956, the mid to the late 1950s, whenever this place opened up, and it was a top secret military base. Kind of like Area 51, like I said. And it closed in 1971 after it was deemed that this experiment that they were doing here was a failure.
Call me a calamity man, but I'm trying as hard as I can to keep a bad luck away from me. I'm doomed to win the life, filled with misery.